Hello YouTube, this is Krosama, and here I have for you today is the High Grade Build Divers Gabaldi Rebake. Now what this kit is essentially a customized Gabaldi Beta. I have not ever built the Gabaldi Beta. I've kind of seen some reviews. It looks like an okay kit, but overall, it's just not aesthetically pleasing to me. But this one, with the aesthetics of pretty much an IBO kit, I think it looks phenomenal. It's definitely a step above what the basic design was for the Gabaldi. I think it's definitely a very good looking kit, but once we get to start talking about the aesthetics, I think you're really gonna see a little bit more of a negative than a plus, just because there's certain aspects of this kit that I'm not really too fond of when it comes to the overall functionality and the posability. But we'll definitely go ahead and take a look at that a little bit later on in the video. But first, I want to go ahead and talk about my thoughts on the kit itself. So the overall detail of the kit is actually pretty good. There's a lot of great opportunities for panel lining. There's some good opportunities just to go ahead and add your own kind of details to it. So if you want to do some extra panel lines, there's definitely going to be some spacing for that. Now, one thing that I'm not going to say it's a con, but one thing you definitely have to be aware of is that there's going to be some stickers that's going to be used for this. And those stickers being essentially for the weapons as well as the shoulder pads, and then you're going to have some of the yellow right here for the shoulders, and then the mono eye black right there. But you can go ahead and easily paint all these. So how was the build process overall? Well, I think it was a very easy build, a very simplistic build at that. Nothing really too standout-ish. Didn't have any kind of issues or any kind of problems when building this kit. And that's a good thing as well as a bad thing, or maybe not as much of a bad thing, but just kind of like, questionable. I'm not saying every kit by Bandai should be very gimmicky or have some kind of unique kind of design aspect to it, but there wasn't anything new here. It was just kind of like, it felt a little bit like building an IBO kit, but it also felt like building just a very bulky, like almost like a Zeon kit. So nothing really too unique here in my opinion, but I think overall the build process is very simple and should take the average builder only a couple hours. So I went with a more weathered approach. Basically what I wanted to do is just add a little bit of like cracks in the armor, which I did a little bit on the front skirts, the back skirts, the leg, as well as the shoulders. I did a couple of like chipping, like actual like battle damage chipping, and then I used some German gray for the chipping effect. So I used a very thin detail paintbrush and kind of drew along the lines of the edges, and then I also used a sponge to kind of do a another like chipping effect on the edges as well. I think I should have been a little bit more subtle. I think I went too crazy, and I probably should have put a little bit more emphasis on the legs, to be honest. But it kind of is what it is. It's a learning process, so even when I don't do as well, or if I'm make some type of mistakes, I do learn from it and I try and improve myself on the next build. But I think just kind of showing you a little bit of how you can make this kit a little bit better. If you guys are really good at doing weathering, then I think that this kit, even though you can get away with making a straight build of the weathering, but just imagine how you're doing it with an actual painted kit. So if you can, I would have personally probably preferred to paint this kit, but I just didn't want to put the time and resources into this kit because I like it, but I don't like it that much. But I think it would have looked way better if I would have went ahead and painted it first and then did all the weathering to it. Now this kit is going to come with a lot of extra parts right over here. Mostly all is just going to be the Gabaldi Beta. So I'm pretty sure you can actually recreate the entire Gabaldi beta with as many extra pieces on these runners as I see. The only thing I did not see was a shield, but it does come with the gun and it comes with the hands and pretty much like, you know, the skirts, feet, head. So I'm 100% sure that you can actually make a desert camo Gabaldi beta with this kit. So if you want to utilize these for something else, you definitely can. But I honestly wouldn't understand if you just, you know, bought this to make a Gabaldi desert camo or like desert style suit. Just buy a regular Gabaldi beta, paint it, and then be done with it, because I think that's a lot cheaper than this kit overall. Alright, so let's go ahead and take a look at the articulation. Starting with the head looks really good. Obviously the sticker should be right there for the mono eye. And then also the back right here, I painted that white because it showed it being white in the line art, so I decided to go ahead and paint that white instead of leaving it all, you know, tan. But yeah, I think it looks really good. The details are fine. The horn looks really good. It's just going to be on a little polycap joint right inside there, so you're going to get basically the standard head movement side to side, left and right, so on and so forth. All right, looking at the body, pretty much the body details are really good. Loved everything about it. I think the front vents and everything looks really cool. Now looking at the details on the inside of the torso, this is gonna be on like a little polycap joint right there, and it's actually pretty loose. So I would have to like put some nail polish or something on there to go ahead and tighten it up. But you get a little bit of an ab crunch right here, and anything further is really gonna just pop it out. So just be aware of that. And then also it's gonna be able to go side to side like normal. All right, so let's take a look at the arms. Well, basically for the shoulders parts, first, they're gonna be able to slide out like so. So I don't know if you can really see, but there is a sliding out gimmick. So this is just gonna allow it to get just way more range of posability like so. So front, back, up, and down. So I think that's really good, and obviously you can spin all the way around as well. And the shoulders themselves are actually pretty nice, so I went ahead and painted some white right inside there just because I think I seen it in the line art. And then obviously painted the yellow right here and the white right up here. Now these little parts right here, these can actually move individually as well. Not really too sure the significance of them, but yeah, those little parts can move. And then this part right here for the arm, it can basically move outwards as well as inwards. And then for the elbow, this can actually move around by itself, basically 360, but it's a little bit stiff, so just be aware of that. And you can also get a 90 degree bend. Now you can also rotate the forearm like so. So instead of having it kind of like on the side like that, you can kind of have it more face up. And it's going to give it a little bit extra of a bend right there. So if you want to go ahead and have that little extra bend, you're just going to have to rotate it right here at the base of the elbow. But it's going to be a little bit stiff, at least that's how it's been for me. So I'll just go ahead and watch out for that. Then you're also gonna have this little open hand right here, so nothing really too special. Basically gonna be on like a little ball joint right there. And looking at the waist, basically the front skirts can move up like so. That's pretty much gonna be it for front skirts. And then for the side, they can move out about that much. And then the back skirt really is not gonna do too much except for stay right there. Now taking a look at the legs, legs have some pretty decent articulation, so they'll be able to go out that much and then go forwards. If you kind of like maybe move the skirt around, it can go a little bit further out, but that's generally the furthest I can go ahead and get it, unless I'm kind of like moving it around or trying to like make it look all odd. But yeah, that's pretty much going to be the furthest. And looking at the knee, basically gonna have two points of articulation, one right up here, one at the bottom. But it's still just not gonna have great, posability, because it's gonna have the front skirt kind of blocking the way, as well as the back skirt blocking. So you're really gonna have to kind of maneuver around if you're gonna want that little extra bend, but probably just get used to about, I'll say about that much. And for the feet, you're really not gonna get too much special, when it comes to the posability. Not really too much on a kind of like side pivot. This side is actually pretty decent, but you're gonna have it come all the way up about that much and all the way back about that much. All right, so let's take a look at the weapon accessories. The first thing we're gonna take a look at is going to be the knuckle. Basically, the knuckle guard is kind of like as you see it. It's just a little part that goes over the fist, and it can go ahead and punch the enemies if it sees necessary. And the next thing we're gonna take a look at is gonna be the high caliber howitzer. Basically, this is kind of like a mortar round, which essentially just fires it in the air, and it kind of goes on an arc and hits the enemy instead of it being like an actual like rocket and just, you know, propelling forward. But the articulation on this is essentially just going to be coming over the shoulder about that much, maybe just a little bit more. So yeah, that's about the furthest is going to go. Which I mean, this would be good for like more close range. But if this mobile suit is actually going to be at a distance, then it's best to go ahead and have it at an angle. And it's also going to have a nice little shield that comes with it. So it should be a white sticker that goes right here, but I went ahead and painted that. Underneath it is going to be fairly plain, and it's going to also have a smoothbore weapon right here. So in case the enemy comes a little bit closer, it can go ahead and fire off a mid-range shot. And it connects right here on the forearm. So the next accessory we're going to take a look at is going to be the hammer pliers. What this is essentially a hammer part right here, and then it also turns into a pair of pliers so it can go ahead and crush its enemies with ease. Now these little white parts right here are all actually supposed to be stickers, but just easily, you know, painting on the inside, putting down some primer and then just painting it was actually very simplistic. And right here on the back skirt, you can actually mount the hammer pliers right here on the back. Just like that. And here's a comparison with the Gabaldi rebake to the rebake Full City. So I don't see where people were really drawing the comparisons that this was like essentially a Full City type of kit. There's comparisons that can be drawn as far as the feel, like the kind of theme of it. But overall, there's like no similarities between these two kits at all. I cannot really find I guess you could maybe say the colors, but that's pretty much where you can like draw the line. Other than that, these kits are going to be completely different. So there was never any kind of, parts customized from the Full City. I think, Koichi just basically drew his inspiration, from this kit. And here's a comparison with it and the Build Diver unit. So it's definitely going to tower right over it, and it's going to be a lot more bulky than the Build Diver. But it's, I mean, they're a great team. So if you really want something that's going to be more ground oriented alongside all your kind of more super robotish type suits, this will look really good with them, at least in my opinion. So I cannot wait to have this alongside all the rest of the Forces kits. And overall, it's going to be looking really, really good on my shelf. And so in conclusion, I think overall, the kit definitely looks really amazing. It does have some kind of shortfalls, essentially with the posability, which I'll go ahead and I'll cover in the pose video. But it's just not really that amazing when, you know, trying to do certain poses, just due to limitations of both the knees and a little bit on the elbows. But overall, hey, I think you can go ahead and still kind of pull off some pretty good dynamic poses, even regardless of the shortfalls. Now, whether or not you should go ahead and paint this kit, I think it's kind of up to you whether or not you really do like this kit. But if it's kind of just an okay kit to you, I think some detail painting, some little bit of weathering will actually do it justice. So it's really up to you on how you're actually going to go ahead and approach it. But I think it looks fine, even, you know, just pretty much out of the box. Well, that's it for me, guys. So overall, I think it's a really awesome suit, really easy build, has some pretty cool nifty accessories, and you know, I just love Iron Blood Orphans, so that kind of like grounded desert aesthetic really just kind of, you know, nails it for me. But overall, that's it for me, guys. Definitely thanks for watching. Please rate, comment, subscribe if you haven't already, and definitely stay tuned for more videos much like these. And if you have any kind of recommendations or comments, definitely leave them in the comments section below. But that's it for me, guys. I'll see y'all in the next review. Bye-bye.